Morning again. Remember our question from yesterday? Why doesn't the Bible tell us about the Ice Age? Jemima F., age 10, from Ireland. Verse they start off with is Genesis 7:11. On that day, all the fountains of the great deep were broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened. Genesis 7:11. The Bible is a book of history and altogether true, but God does not reveal everything to us in His book. However, if we look at what we know about the worldwide flood from the Bible, then look at the evidence of glaciers and ice sheets that once covered at least one-third of the earth, we see that the Bible does give us some clues about the Ice Age. A catastrophe as huge as Noah's flood drastically changed the climate on earth, creating conditions perfect for an ice age at the end of the flood. The Bible tells us that the fountains of the deep burst forth. This was unlike anything we can even imagine. This breaking up of the earth caused the oceans to heat up and caused ash and dust to fill the air, blocking out sunlight, making the temperatures on earth cooler. As the warm water from the oceans evaporated into the air, forming clouds, the colder air over the earth caused wintry conditions, lots of snow and ice glaciers. This could have very easily caused an ice age that lasted hundreds of years. When we start with what the Bible tells us, we can then find truth. Look at our verse in Job. Maybe this is a reference to the ice age at the time of Job. And here are those verses. Job 37:9 through 10. And this does sound like ice age conditions. Out of the south cometh the whirlwind, and cold out of the north. By the breath of God frost is given, and the breath of the waters is straitened. Okay, let's see our question for tomorrow. Since we all came from Adam and Eve, shouldn't we all have the same color skin? Very good question. Emily B., age 8. So we'll talk about that tomorrow. Have a great day. Bye.